In this travel vlog, you will see some tips on what to do and see in Sydney in 1 week. First thing I had to do after arriving in Sydney was to get myself online. Luckily, Optus and Vodafone stores are located in the arrival hall of the airport, and they were literally the first shops I saw. We already had an Optus SIM card from our trip to Sydney in 2015, so I wanted to buy it again, but the staff in the Optus shop told me that it could take up to 2 hours to activate it, which was a deal breaker because I needed mobile broadband straight away. So I decided to get a SIM card from the Vodafone shop instead. Guys in Vodafone shop guaranteed me that their service will be activated immediately, so they were the right choice for me. My wife, who was already in Sydney, advised me to buy an Opal card for easy payment on public transport. So Opal was the second thing I was hunting for. I got it easily and quickly as well from WH Smith shop, which was located nearby to the Vodafone and Optus shop. So I was all set and ready to hop on the train. The train station is located in the airport, which is very convenient. My wife already texted me with the train and bus I should take to get to Manly Vale, the place where we were staying, so things were easy for me. Train from the airport costs about 18 bucks and bus was about 5 bucks. I arrived at my wife's sister's place at about noon and had a short nap. That afternoon we went downtown to Sydney Opera House to see the Unbelievables. On our way to Sydney Opera House we stopped off for an ice cream at Gelato Messina Circular Quay. The selection of flavors was massive and they all looked fabulous. I went for macadamia nuts ice cream, which was delicious. We continued to Sydney Opera House after we were done with the ice cream. After getting tickets in Sydney Opera House, we went for a very quick drink in the Opera House bar. A nice view from the Opera House to Sydney Harbour and Sydney Harbour Bridge. It was not allowed to shoot the Unbelievables show itself, so I don't have any footage from it. I enjoyed the view of Sydney Harbour Bridge and of the boats in harbour during the show's break. The Unbelievables show wasn't all that great anyway, but it is a great way to see the Opera House from inside. In 2015 we went for the Sydney Opera House tour, which costs about 40 bucks. The Unbelievables show costs about 65 bucks for the cheapest ticket, plus some booking fee, so it is a little more expensive, but I liked the show more than the Opera House tour. You get plenty of information and they walk you to much more rooms on the tour, but I have forgotten a lot of what they said since, and you can Google it anyway. So I enjoyed the show more, even if The Unbelievables was nowhere near the best one. After the Sydney Opera House, we went to Manly by ferry. The views of Sydney Opera House and Sydney Harbour Bridge were spectacular. We could also see some Australian Navy ships on our way to Manly. After the ferry dropped us off in Manly, we went to Ivanhoe Hotel for dinner. If you are visiting Australia, make sure to have a lemon, lime and bitters, which is Australia's national drink. And it is a must try taste while you are on your Australian trip. I like it very much myself. It is delicious refreshment on a warm sunny day. After a dinner, we went for a walk to Manly Beach and then we walked to our place in Manly Vale. My second day in Sydney, I woke up at about 4:45 because of jet lag. So I decided to walk to Manly Beach, which is only about half an hour walk from Manly Vale. I came to Manly Beach just before sunrise, which was at about 5:40 on 23rd December, so I took quick time-lapse on my camera. On my way back, I got some pastry from Manly Bakery, 31 Sydney Road in Manly. Pastry from Manly Bakery was delicious and reasonably cheap. After breakfast, we went to Shelley Beach in Manly. The car park was already full and it was tricky to get parking. I had my GoPro with me, so I took some snorkeling footage. Thank you. In the afternoon, we went to Divai Beach, where we spent the whole afternoon. My folks went to Divai Beach by car, but because there were too many of us, I went there by bus. I took the Beeline bus from Manly Way, which is a perfect connection to the northern beaches. It was a windy day, which brought some waves, but other than wind, the weather was fantastic. Many of Australia's beaches have rips, powerful currents that can drag a swimmer out to sea, so always swim between the red and yellow flags on patrolled beaches. On my third day in Sydney, 24th of December, I had a jet lag and could not sleep, so I walked to Manly Beach again in early morning. I made it just before a sunrise, so I took a time lapse of the sunrise again. This time I knew exactly where to expect the sun, so the time lapse looks much nicer than one from the day before. It was a beautiful sunny morning and the beach was already alive, even though it was only just after 6. There was already a few people on the beach and some runners on the promenade. Residents of Manly have a healthy lifestyle and are active very early in the morning. In the afternoon we went to Fingal Bay, but as there were 6 of us, we did not fit into one car. So I had to rent one. We made a mistake in that we started to search for a rental car only a few days before, and all the nearby rentals already had everything booked out. Finally, we got lucky and found a car in Avis on Pittwater Road in DY, which is not so far from Manly Way. But Avis is of course not the cheapest rental company. We paid about $350 for the 3 days, but the car was new and we had both insurance and road assistance included. It was a Toyota Corolla in perfect condition. The drive to Fingal Bay took almost 3 hours, but it was worth it. Fingal Bay is a gorgeous place with a white sand beach about 1 mile long and gentle waves. We had a very good relaxing time on Fingal Bay Beach and I really recommend it to anyone who has some spare time for a one-day trip during their stay in Sydney. At the end of the Fingal Bay is Fingal Spit, a place where you can cross by sand to Shark Island during low tide. But as they say here, it may be quite a dangerous thing to do if there is any water over it. There are reports of people drowning while attempting to cross the Fingal Bay sand spit. Swimming is not advised because of strong currents, dangerous tides, the sudden drops, no life-saving service and sharks. After a day on the beach, we bought some seafood in Fisherman's Wharf Seafood's shop in Nelson Bay and went for dinner to Mavericks on the bay in the Albora Marina in Nelson Bay. Food there was delicious and the spot was beautiful right on the waterfront with views of the marina. I woke up very early because of jet lag, so I got tired and the 3 hours drive back to Sydney weren't fun at all. On Christmas morning we went to Manly Nordhead, from where there are stunning views to Sydney skyline. Unfortunately, the weather was desperate, so the pictures which I took were not that great. After Manly Nordhead, we drove to the famous Bondi Beach. It is about 50 minutes of drive from Manly Vale to Bondi Beach when the traffic is light. Despite Christmas Day being cloudy and windy, Bondi Beach and Bondi Promenade were very busy. I took some video footage and few time lapses, but the wind was stronger than my chubby gorilla pot, so my time lapses are a little shaky. Hare Krishna movement was busy on Christmas Day as well. After Bondi Beach, we decided to drive to Watson's Bay, which is nearby. It is possible to walk the whole way from Bondi Beach to Watson's Bay on Federation Cliff Walk, which is about 5 kilometers. We did not have time to walk it, so we drove and left our car at the beginning of Watson's Bay on the old Southhead Road, where it is easy to park up the car even on a busy day. So I can show you at least the Watson's Bay part of the coastal cliff walk. Lookouts on the cliff walk are stunning. Probably the best lookout is the Gap Lookout with magnificent views. The view from Watson's Bay Beach near Watson's Bay Wharf to Sydney skyline was spectacular. I met a pelican on the beach near Marine Parade, but the pelican didn't like my camera. I guess he didn't want to be put on the spot. On our drive back to Manly Vale, we got caught by boats on Speed Bridge and we had to wait a little to let them pass. We had our Christmas dinner when we arrived to our folks' place. On the morning of December 26th, we went to Manly for a walk on the beach promenade. It was about 8 a.m. and a cloudy day, but the beach and promenade were active as usual. I took a small time lapse of a busy beach. On our way back to Manly Vale, we stopped in Brizel Bar, a German bakery in Manly, to buy some bread and pastry for breakfast. There are many various parrots around in Sydney. We saw this one on our way to check out some sales at Westfield Warringah Shopping Mall. After some quick shopping, we went to the Lindt Chocolate Cafe on 53 Martin Place, which is known because of the terrorist attack in December 2014. Lindt Cafe is like chocolate heaven with delicious cakes, ice cream, coffee and other treats. Me and my folks had hot chocolate, cappuccino, Lindt Decadent Chocolate Milkshake, Lindt Favorites Sharing Platter and Lindt Chocolate Lovers Ultimate Platter. After the Lindt Chocolate Cafe, we went to Sea Life Sydney Aquarium in Darling Harbour. My folks had tickets to visit four different attractions, but I had to buy a ticket at the door which costs $46, so I recommend you to buy a ticket for four attractions which costs only $70. And you can also skip the queue at the door which was massive. That big fish behind is dugong, called also sea cow because of the huge amount of seagrass it eats. In the Sydney Aquarium, dugongs eat lettuce threaded into specially weighted racks, which sit on the bottom of the dugong's display. This is the Penguin Expedition ride and it's included in all tickets. You can also find out the name of every penguin and its basic information like personality, for example. Discovery Kids Rock Pool allows you to see and touch the marine creatures commonly found in rock pools like sea starfish. The 27th of December was a nice warm sunny day. Same as every morning, I went to Manly again. I took a time-lapse of Manly Beach almost on the same spot as day before, only this time with nice sunny weather. I walked on the Marine Parade from Manly Beach to Shelly Beach. I took a small time lapse of Shelly Beach. It was a gorgeous day, so we decided to drive to Palm Beach. It is only about a 40-minute drive from Manly Vale to Palm Beach. We left our car at the car park near Governor Phillip Park. The location of the car park is very convenient, but it is rather pricey. We left our car literally next to Palm Beach. We did a small hike to Barrenjoey Head Lighthouse, and at the beginning we passed Station Beach. The water of Station Beach is very calm and it's suitable for families with little kids. The views from hike to Barrenjoey Head Lighthouse were spectacular.
He actually does DJs, he does like Arabic.
What's the name?
Marble?
After the hike to Barrenjoey Head Lighthouse, we went to Palm Beach. In the evening, we went for dinner to Ashiana Indian Restaurant. The food was delicious there. On our last day in Sydney, we went on a half-day trip to Manly Dam. On our way to Manly Dam, we saw St. Andrew's Cross Spider, whose bite is not toxic to humans, and St. Andrew's Cross Spiders are generally not aggressive. Nearby Manly Dam, you can sometimes see kangaroos, but we didn't see any. 2 days out of the 7 we were in Sydney were not that hot, so the fire danger rating was only high today. Manly Dam walks are beautiful, but don't forget to watch your step. Manly Dam is perfect for walking and mountain biking, but also for swimming, water skiing, canoeing, kayaking and fishing. Manly Dam is also a very nice place for a picnic. Thank you. Manly Dam was the last place which we visited in Sydney, and after Manly Dam, me and my wife went to Sydney International Airport to catch our flight to Auckland for a 3 weeks long road trip in New Zealand. Travel vlogs from New Zealand road trip will follow on this channel, so please stay tuned and subscribe, please. Other nice places to visit in Sydney are Sydney Tower, Darling Harbour, Sydney Harbour Bridge and Symbio Wildlife Park. Thanks for watching, guys. Please leave questions and comments below, like my video and subscribe. Thanks for watching.